thank you, Chamber, for this event and giving me the opportunity to be here this evening. My name is Tommy Mark Weisenbaker Jr. I was born and raised here in Valdosta. Does anybody here remember Little Griffin Hospital? That's where I was born. It doesn't exist today. After Little Griffin was finally new general, now we have South Florida. I've seen a lot of change in my years. I was born October 10, 1951. I'm a property owner and a proud property taxpayer. I have 43 years of business experience. I began in a family business with my father in Lake Park truck stop on the Florida line. And I was in that business for 10 years with him. I left it and went to work for Griffin Corporation on Rocky Ford Road. Enjoyed that as a supervisory management and production manager. And from there I went to chemical specialist, Lane Renfrew, one of the best men that I've ever worked for. I really enjoyed Lane. After chemical specialist, I purchased and built a Mako Auto Paint franchise in Mobile, Alabama. And I held on to that business for 5 years and decided that I wanted to come back to Valdosta, which I never changed my residence. Carol would come over one weekend and I would come to Valdosta the other weekend. And that really got old and tiresome. So I sold that business and did good, made a profit. Came back to Valdosta and got the real estate business. Started out with Emmett Pinkston in Lake Park. Wound up with Remax. Spent 15 years hustling real estate. And I currently hold a real estate brokerage license. I'm basically inactive in the real estate. Currently, I'm a co-owner with my wife, Carol, in a business called Custom Relocation Specialist. We call it CRS. I went to Bubba Burnett's feed store a couple of weeks ago, and I walked in the door, and Bubba said, "Oh, Mr. Politician Man." And I backed up, held my hands up, and I said, "No, I'm not a politician. I'm a businessman." And that's the way I want to be known on the Board of Commissioners for Lowndes County, a businessman, not a politician. My years of business experience will be used to decrease physical waste, I want to support all businesses, large and small, and importantly, I want to create an environment where business wants to locate here. I plan to work closely with our industrial authority and give them the tools to attract new industry. And fill our industrial parks. We have about 500 acres of space in our industrial park that is ready for new business. And if we bring in the right business, we will see some growth. I plan on putting a lid on spending, and I'd like to implement policies that reduce taxes. Everybody likes to hear that. I believe in being a good steward of our environment, protecting our woods and waters. And I think it's very important that our government stays on top of infrastructure in the county, paving new roads, maintaining the existing roads. We have some new projects on board now. One of them is the Borden Pond Road, which is in dire need of paving and some construction now. We should continue to update and maintain our water and sewer systems. We don't want to wake up in the county one day and be like Valdosta and be behind an eight ball with an antiquated sewer system or with bad water systems. So staying on those systems is something that I would work for. Everybody's heard about the waste disposal problems we've had in Lowndes County. I would like to reestablish waste disposal sites for bulk items. One in the south end of the county, one in the about the middle, and one in the north end of the county. One people will have a place to take old mattresses, TVs, refrigerators, stoves, these kinds of things. Instead of taking them to the deer room, dropping them off on the road out of our county. Along that same line, I want to create a policy to give our residents back their choice for disposing of household garbage, their choice of who they want to use, and work at that strongly. Moody Air Force Base is one of the most important things we have in this county. It's a vital part of our economy, and we should do all we can to support our Air Force Base and its thousands of employees. You know, we're the 27th largest county in the state. We're the 21st most populous county in the state. I believe we should act now to prepare for the future growth that's sure to come. And the estimates of that growth is the current population of 117,000 to 160,000 by 2030. That's quite a bit of growth. We have a lot to do. With I-75, north and south, US 84, and US 133 east and west, which are being four lane, and I-10 to the south of our county, we are strategically located to attract a variety of business. As we say in real estate, location, location, location. We have a location. So we need to roll up our sleeves and get the job done. I ask for your vote.